Hi everyone, welcome to Getting Started in CKEditor 5 in 5 Minutes. In this video, I'm going to show you how to quickly integrate CKEditor into your web application. So let's jump right in. In order to set up CKEditor 5, you have 4 options. The first is the CKEditor 5 builder, which we're going to discuss today. It offers live previews, multiple integration possibilities, as well as a code generator at the end that will just help you copy paste and set it up right out of the box. Then, of course, you have your standard NPM and CDN options, as well as a zip file that allows you to download and include ready-to-use files directly in your projects. For the example today, we're going to be building an app that reviews company documents. And here I have this professional development company policy document. It includes eligibility, reimbursement procedures, but also these specific formatting niches like lists and images and tables, in addition to comments and tracking changes and revision history and things like that. Now I have all of my requirements that I need out of this editor for this specific document and documents like this, and I'm going to take a look at what I can do with CKEditor. Now that we have all of our requirements, let's take a look at the CKEditor 5 builder. Step 1 of the builder process is to select the editor UI you want from over 10 available presets. This allows you to choose the best starting point for your specific needs. For this demo and example, I'm going to choose the classic editor starter. All right, let's move on to step 2. In step 2 of the builder, we need to make sure we're avoiding some of the formatting issues and that the document that I pull into my editor actually works with the editor itself. So in order to do that, I'm actually going to scroll down over here and enable the content conversion and embedding feature. This is going to allow me to pull in that document from earlier and see how it works in the editor. All right. I noticed that it is missing some of the formatting, including images, the text, the comments, as well as lists, and even the table over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add all of that. I'm going to say bring in all the text formatting, content and block formatting that you have, as well as images, the ability to handle lists, tables. And I would also would like some collaboration features right out of the box. All right, now that we have this set up, I'm going to test this one more time to make sure it fits all of my requirements. And look at that, right out of the box, after import, I have my comments over here, the image as it was there. I also saw lists, as well as the table, and everything formatted just as I would want it in my editor. So this looks great to me in terms of all the features that I need. And I'm going to go to step 3 of the builder, which is you get to choose your toolbar and how your toolbar is configured. I like how it is right now, and I'm going to go ahead and use the default and go to the next step. And that's really all you need to set up and install CKEditor within the builder. But before we get to install it in our own coding editor, what you will first need is a license key. Since we're using some premium features, having a license key is essential. I've already got mine, but if you don't have one yet, you can sign up for a free trial to access all of the premium features CKEditor 5 has to offer. So let's set up our options. For this demo, I am going to go with vanilla.js as my technology stack. We're going to use the cloud CDN integration method. And finally, I'm going to go ahead and click download project. This way, everything is ready to go right out of the box. Once I've downloaded my sample project, I'm going to open it up in my code editor of choice. And as you can see, right out of the box, I have been provided with all of the HTML I need to get started, as well as all of the JavaScript that I need. And I should be able to get this started. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and say npm start. And look at that. My editor is ready to set up and go right out of the box. Let's go ahead and import that document one last time and make sure it works in my own web application. This is looking great right now. And there's one more thing I'd like to do. What I'm going to do is I'm setting it up for real-time collaboration. I'm loading the editor in 2 browsers to see it in action. So as I start making a few changes in the editor over here, you can see those changes being reflected in the other editor in real time. So that's it. In just 5 minutes, we have set up a fully functional CKEditor 5 instance with real-time collaboration, images, ordered and unordered lists, tracking changes, comments, and so much more. I hope you found this tutorial helpful for getting started with CKEditor 5. Thank you so much for watching, and happy coding!